Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I briefly tell you, my name is Mel. I'm an Uruguayan neuroscientist. I am currently in Germany doing a PhD in molecular biomedicine. And on the side, I have this project where I create scientific content about and for Latinx communities. But why stop right there, right? So let's interview everyone in the world because everyone is interesting and has cool stuff to tell us, so why not? Literally, that was my idea behind this international science series. And today we have a special guest all the way from Canada, but he's gonna tell us a lot of cool stuff. He's gonna talk about a group of elements in the periodic table called the lanthanides, that they have really cool properties, and he's gonna tell us applications of this kind of research towards things like nanotechnology, quantum computing, and even environmental sciences. So it's very like a huge range of things that you can do with that. So I'm very excited to hear this today. So give a warm welcome to Cody. Hi, Cody. Thank you so much for giving your time for this. It's a really a pleasure to have you here.
Hey, Mel. I'm very excited to be featured on your international science show. Thanks for having me here.
So to start, where are you from? What did you study? Tell us a bit about the story.
Yeah, so I was born and raised in Niagara Falls, Canada. At the Canadian-American border is where the spectacular waterfall is. I know you said you've never seen it, but you'll have to come visit at least once in your life. It's truly beautiful.
Wow, yes, I can imagine. It must be beautiful. I would really like to visit. I will take you up on that. And did you study there or...
I completed my Bachelor of Science double majoring in Chemistry and Biology at Brock University, which is our local university here in Niagara. I chose my specific major because I've always been fascinated by the chemical sciences and the vastness of their research. It is truly remarkable to me how in such a short cosmic time frame that we've been able to figure out so much about the matter that makes up the world and everything around us.
Yes, it's completely fascinating. And within this topic, which topics are your favorite or what did you choose to specialize in?
As a young researcher, I would classify my favorite research topics as synthetic inorganic chemistry towards nanotechnology and material science. I'm particularly interested in studying lanthanide metal complexes. Although at the bottom of the periodic table in the F block, among some notably dangerous elements, most of the lanthanides are relatively safe to handle and their complexes have a wide variety of properties that people study.
Whoa, that's super interesting. I'm a biologist and like I had to study chemistry, of course, but usually we will neglect those elements on the F block. So it's really interesting to know more about what you can do with these kind of things. Can you tell us a bit of, yeah, some examples, maybe things that you have worked on or studied or I don't know, tell us a bit more about this.
So I presently study two properties in lanthanide systems. Primarily, I'm interested in studying single molecule magnet behavior. Essentially, what this property is that when you have a complex and you cool it down to very low temperatures and you magnetize it from an external source, it retains this encoded magnetization upon heating it up until eventually it has enough thermal energy where it can relax its magnetic moment from this fixed state. This is important in the scope of applying these systems to data storage miniaturization and quantum computing. These complexes have the potential to allow us to do things like store information and compute substantially faster than traditional computers by innovation on the nanoscale and the molecular level.
Whoa, that's fascinating. And I think all the viewers, even if they are not from a field of science, they understand this concept. Like, we would like to have smaller and lighter computers and cell phones, TVs, you name the device, and also at the same time more powerful, or like being able to store more storage, for example, more pictures, more music, whatever. So there's an interest in this industry, in this field, to produce ways of like reducing the size of the components of these elements so we can make things faster, but also lighter and smaller. And within this, what are you particularly doing? Like, what kind of things someone can do to improve or to do research on this or work on this?
Also, a different property that I'm quite interested in studying is the green or environmental catalytic behavior of some of my prepared lanthanide complexes. The capability of some of these lanthanide systems to facilitate fixation of some greenhouse gases like carbon dioxide into useful products is something I think is definitely important for today's world. Thanks to collaboration with some amazing colleagues at Memorial University in St. John's, Canada, I've been able to see some very interesting catalytic behavior in some of my complexes.
That's really cool because it also has then an application, as you said, like with this ability of fixating greenhouse gases to environmental science, to make our industries and our technology more like environmental friendly. This is really interesting. Could you tell us something really interesting that has been discovered in this field. It can be by a group that you know, can be something you read somewhere while you were studying that maybe you want to share with the public, something cool and interesting that people can take home.
There are a couple of cool research results that came to mind right away when you asked this question, but I'll share with you the one that I find the most fascinating. So I recently prepared a pair of dysprosium complexes where the only difference is the terminal molecule that's bound. One has a water molecule bound to it and the other has a tetrahydrofuran or THF molecule bound to it. The interesting part about this pair is that depending on which molecule is bound, the single molecule magnet behavior turns on and off respectively. The reason behind this phenomenon lies within some varying intermolecular interactions between the two complexes, but overall we have now just developed a synthetic means towards developing a single molecule magnet with its very own molecular on-off switch for its magnetism, which I found to be very cool.
Wow, this is really fascinating indeed. You know, it's funny because a couple of weeks ago, I interviewed another scientist from Costa Rica that he is also working on nanotechnology. Unfortunately, the video is in Spanish, so I don't know how many of you will be able to understand it. But we were also talking about this. With this in mind of wanting to miniaturize things, you go into nanotechnology, you want things that act like machines, like mechanisms at a nanoscale, so the smallest thing you can that does some work for you. So being able to play around with these elements and creating this on and off switch is really, really nice thing in this context. I don't have any idea what kind of things you can build with this because this field is so far away from what I do, but I can appreciate that this is kind of the building blocks or the foundation for this kind of cool things. So it's really nice. So now I would like to ask you, you already gave a lot of explanations, but to be a bit more explicit, since we have people from different backgrounds watching this video, could you give us some words on what do you think is the importance of having people like you developing these kind of areas?
In my opinion, I think both areas are important in different ways to progress our society. Environmental research in any capacity, whether it be large or small scale, it really makes a difference. This research is not just chemistry, but it takes on any form. I think overall, protecting the environment and promoting a sustainable future is something that we'll see gain more and more importance as industry continues to grow.
Yes, I do hope so, also because we need it. We need to improve our sustainability, you know, our natural resources management.
For molecular magnetism, this is one example of several where nanotechnology is being applied in material science and in society. The importance of so many people working in areas like these is the aspect of innovation. We are at a point now where researchers are pushing our technology to be faster, stronger, and more efficient. Companies like Apple, SpaceX, and IBM are coming out with ideas that were started with somebody's lab work or somebody's idea that are now presenting game-changing effects to the way our society functions.
Yes, those are very good examples of in which kind of things this kind of research can develop into. I would also like to ask you if you have any piece of advice, any tips for young students maybe that they are watching us right now.
The best advice I would give young students aspiring to a career in science, honestly, is to fall in love with what you do. If you are truly passionate for your field, putting in the work will feel effortless. Playing the field, for me, feels like a hobby, like playing a sport or being part of a club. It became a regular part of my life. I wanted to work at and learn more about it every single day. When you develop a passion for what you do, as the saying goes, you'll never work a day in your life.
Yes, I agree. And especially I liked what you said at the beginning, that if you have a passion for this, putting in the work will feel effortless. So maybe not entirely effortless, but yes, you have to devote a lot of hours, a lot of time, a lot of effort, some weekends, whatever, that you have, maybe you want to do something else and you really have to dedicate yourself to this, especially in the first years that you're studying and you're amassing an amazing amount of information in your brain and getting a lot of practical experience and so on. And yes, if you really like it, you will feel that it's less of a burden and it's more like an enjoyment. You will feel fulfilled. At least that happened to me as well. Well, those were all the questions I had for today. So thank you very much, Cody, for being here with us, giving your time for this.
Thank you very much. I'm very glad to be here. Before we finish up, I would like to say thanks to my research supervisor and mentor, Professor Theoharis Stamatatos at the University of Patras, for his support and inspiring me through my young career. And thanks to you, Mel, for having me. It was a pleasure to do this interview with you.
Yes, thank you. The pleasure is all mine. And if I ever go to Niagara Falls, I already know who to call. And thank you guys for your attention. If you like this video, I invite you to subscribe to the channel, to give thumbs up to the video, to support the project. I also have a Patreon account if someone would like to make a donation to keep this channel growing and free for everyone. Also invite you to leave down comments suggesting topics that you would like to see in the future in this channel. And if you are a Spanish speaking person, or if you like learn Spanish and you want to practice it, I invite you to check the rest of the videos in this channel, which are meant to do scientific outreach in Latinx communities. And yeah, see you in the next video. Bye bye. Yeah.